This is the Eye Seduction Channel.
We started talking a little bit before off camera about your favorite music and about what you think about today's pop culture, music, Jonas Brothers, etc.
Well, it's hard to say because I have found it difficult to keep up with a lot of contemporary popular music. My favorite music of all time is Motown. It makes me feel good. I'm blue and I want to feel better. I put on the Marvelettes or Sam and Dave or Marvin Gaye or the Four Tops or, any of that music. Major Lance, how many people know about him? I mean, any of the stuff that Holland Dozier Holland wrote, I just adore. I mean, Stevie Wonder from when he really was little Stevie Wonder. I mean, I have those early albums. I loved Dionne Warwick in the 60s. I love black music. It's the best contribution to world culture that this country has given to anybody, anywhere, bar none. It's fabulous. And I grew up with loving jazz. I knew who Art Tatum was when I was 4 years old. My dad was an amateur jazz pianist, and I had, music in the home my whole life, live, and it was just, I saw Thelonious Monk for the first time live in 1959. My very first music photograph actually was a Thelonious Monk in 1964 when he performed at Rhode Island School of Design, and I did a record cover with my photographs of him as part of a graphic design project to design a record cover, and I photographed Thelonious Monk and did a record cover for him. It never was used, of course. It was a student project, but I got an A on it. and so that's what was interesting when the Fillmore East opened. That was my introduction to, to the white music. I mean, it wasn't that I didn't know rock and roll and the Everly Brothers and Elvis and all of that stuff that was coming along, but I was never an Elvis fan, and I still am not, because I knew the original black music that he was, cribbing for, that he was reinterpreting for white audiences, and I resented that because I liked the original blues. I mean, I listened to that, I listened to the jug bands, all those folkways recordings, and I knew that music, so Elvis didn't do it for me. I liked the real thing, and that's still true. But I have to say honestly that I'm very, very ignorant about, new rock and roll. I mean, I did, I liked Hanson when they first started out, bubblegum kids music, but I have some, and I have, because I happened to have a chance to photograph them when they performed at Wetlands a few years ago, and I have some really nice pictures of them. I still do some pictures from time to time when I have the chance, and I try to be in New York every March to see the Allman Brothers at the Beacon, which is the closest thing to recreating the Fillmore East experience today that we can still enjoy, and I'm on very good terms with the Allman Brothers organization, and so I usually get a backstage pass and get to hang out with them. So I know it's not the musicians. Greg Allman doesn't know me. I've gotten to know Butch Trunks over the years, and he has some of my pictures. He's been a nice, but mostly it's the it's the organizational people like Kirk West and Shelley Balfour, who's one of their tour managers. So I have a great time. I have to say, for anyone today who wants to have an idea of what that experience was like, and if you like the Allman Brothers, don't miss them at the Beacon in March. They've so far they just celebrated their 40th anniversary this year, and it was fantastic. The show I went to was Eric Clapton was the special guest, and it was wonderful. Really was.
Well. As I promised, I am going to get you a couple of albums just to keep you rolling on some current stuff. Amalie Rothschild, it's been an honor. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Ken.
Bill Graham is moving out to the stage now, and he wants to say something about the Allman Brothers.
The Allman Brothers have played, I think this is their fourth time.
Yes.
Their first show, they played with the Grateful Dead, which really started it. They've emerged into somewhat of their own Grateful Dead type trick.
There's Bill on stage.
Yeah.
Is he on
mic? Okay, let's... I think it's about time to go to the stage.
Waiting for the cue.
Over the years that we've been doing this, the introductions are usually very short, and this one's going to be short but a little longer than usual. The last few days, we've have had the privilege of working with this particular group, and in the past year or so, we've had them on both coasts a number of times. In all that time, I've never heard the kind of music that this group plays. And last night, we had the good fortune of having them get on stage about 2:30, 3 o'clock, and they walked out of here at 7 o'clock in the morning. And it's not just that they played quantity, and for my amateur ears, in all my life, I've never heard the kind of music that this group plays, the finest contemporary music. We're going to round it off with the best of them all, the Allman Brothers.